हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 818 एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज द यूज ऑफ ट्राइनिटरटोलीन द डीएनटी एंड पिक्रिक एसिड एज ए मिलिट्री एक्सप्लोसिव एंड दिस टीएनटी इज वेरी वेल नोन एक्सप्लोसिव and this is used since 1920 and it was widely used by military in World War I and World War II and this is very safe in the sense that it is not much toxic and it is safe to handle and it is having high power explosion so that's why it is very much suitable to military people to use as a explosive and this trinitrotoluene is manufactured by the same method of nitrating the toluene but it is not in one stage once we are doing the nitration nitrating mixture means when we are treating with concentrated nitric acid with other acid like concentrated sulfuric acid that is called nitrating mixture so in one stage it is a large volume and there will be lot of waste and also the yield will be very poor so that's why it is slowly done in three stages and once it is done in three stages to synthesize TNT the yield is very high and also whatever leftover acids is there inside the container during the reaction that is also recycled and utilized so there will not be the loss of large quantity of nitrating mixture that is the mixture of acids so that's why the TNT is prepared in three stages and it is less sensitive to impact and it is also having good advantage because of its low melting point It has 80.8 degree centigrade low melting point, and that gives the advantage to TNT. And nowadays, TNT, trinitrotoluene, has replaced the picric acid. Picric acid is also one of the military explosive. And in the case of picric acid, the phenol is nitrated, but the phenol as such cannot be nitrated. First, phenol is converted into sulfonic acid and that sulfonic acid is then treated with nitrating mixture that is concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid then it is converted into that is picric acid and the second method of manufacturing of picric acid is from chlorobenzene and from chlorobenzene we can do the nitration with nitrating mixture and we will get the picric acid so I have given here the first one that is your this is your TNT trinitrotoluene this is your toluene this methyl group is there and where 1 2 3 three nitro groups are there and that is actually your 2 4 and 6 so actually it is 2 4 and 6 trinitro So there are once we are doing the nitration of this toluene in three stages, there are some isomeric form also formed, where yes, it may be sometimes 2-4-5 or 2-4-3 like that. But out of all those isomeric formation, the most important one and most effective one is that is 2-4-6 trinitrotoluene, which is very good explosive for military purpose. And when this trinitrotoluene decomposes on decomposition of trinitrotoluene we are getting 3.5 carbon monoxide plus 3.5 carbon plus 2.5 water plus 1.5 nitrogen and 190 kilocalorie energy is released number 1 TNT which is called 2,4,6 trinitrotoluene commonly known as TNT explosive has become the principal military explosive since 1920. So it was manufactured in 1920, and this TNT was widely used during World War I and World War II war. And lot of chemical weapons and toxic weapons and all these nitro derivatives, it was done during 1920s to 50s or 45 during that World War II period. And later on we realized that they are very harmful and dangerous to us. So nowadays the lot of toxic chemicals are prohibited to produce because it is giving lot of harm to human beings. And then it is most widely used explosive because of its economic and safe preparation. It is cheap, more economic, and it is safe to prepare. So that's why this is popular explosive. Low sensitivity to impact, high explosive power, and low toxic effect, and its low melting point, that is 80.8 degree centigrade. So these are all very good quality of trinitrotoluene, TNT. That's why even still today, TNT is widely used and very popular because of its quality. And that quality, I have already mentioned you that it is very economic, and then it's safe to prepare, its toxicity is low, and its sensitivity to impact is high. Impact high explosive power, low toxic effect, and its low melting point. Number two, it is manufactured by three stage nitration of toluene with mixed nitric acids. The three stage nitration, the three stage nitration gives better yield and is more safe than one stage nitration. I have already explained you these things. In one stage nitration, large volume of strong acids mixture at high temperature would be required, and there will be lot of waste will be there, and which will lead to loss of TNT. In three stage nitration, the process, the waste acid from the final stage may be recycled to be used in the initial stage. So number three, the crude TNT means once it is synthesized out of three stages, that is in crude form. So we call it that is crude TNT, and the crude TNT is also known as trioil. So trioil is also known as crude TNT. So this trioil is then washed with water and soda ash to neutralize the excess amount of acid, and then with acidulated 16% Na2SO3 is used to remove the unsymmetrical isomeric form, and those unsymmetrical TNT are 234, 236 and 245 nitrotoluene. And this unsymmetrical TNT, they are not effective. So with this treating, with this it is converted into water soluble sodium nitro sulfonate, and in this way that one is removed. So this is very important point here, how to remove the undesired trinitrotoluene which are unsymmetrical, which are not effective, by converting it into dinitro sulfonate, which is water soluble. The TNT is superior to picric acid because of its low melting point, and it has no tendency to form sensitive salts with any metal. So that is what about TNT explosive. Now picric acid. Picric acid means it is when phenol is nitrated, So that is your 2,4,6 trinitro. Phenol is called picric acid, but it is not possible to directly nitrate the phenol. It has to be converted into sulfonic acid. So number four, the picric acid is 2,4,6 trinitro phenol, cannot be prepared directly by the nitration of phenol, rather than because of the formation of various oxidation byproduct. So lot of oxidation byproduct will be produced if we are doing direct. So that's why it is converted into sulfonic acid. It is therefore manufactured by nitration of phenol 2,4-disulfonic acid. So first phenol is treated with sulfuric acid, and this will be converted into phenol 2,4-disulfonic acid. And this 2,4-disulfonic acid, when it is nitrated in percent of nitric acid, then it is converted into picric acid. So number five, that is the second method of manufacture of picric acid, is starting from chlorobenzene. So the picric acid can also be prepared from chlorobenzene. The latter is not easily oxidized by nitric acid when it is nitrated with concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid. It forms 2,4-dinitro chlorobenzene, that is 2,4-dinitro chlorobenzene. So once chlorobenzene is treated with concentrated nitric acid and sulfuric acid, it will be converted into 2,4-dinitro chlorobenzene, and it is boiled with sodium carbonate solution. This is your sodium bicarbonate solution, and boiling it solution to remove the active chlorine. So in this way, the active chlorine will be removed from here, and you will get 2,4-dinitro phenol. And this to remove the active chlorine, and finally it is again nitrated, means this 2,4-dinitro phenol is again treated with HNO3, concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid, and again nitration will take place, and we will get picric acid. So the picric acid is high explosive. It's a very explosive material, and it's exploding violently on detonation. So with violent explosion is there on detonation, but TNT however has almost replaced picric acid nowadays for commercial or military purpose. Mostly very popular explosive, that is TNT, not picric acid. So with this I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture. So how many minutes?